Hello students, we are studying chapter 1, that is crop production and management. We have already discussed about various agricultural practices such as preparation of soil, sowing seeds, irrigation, crop protection. After all these, following all these tasks by the farmer, when crop is protected from various enemies such as insects, pests, drought, flood, various diseases. Then when crop is ripe, after that there is the step of harvesting. Harvesting is the process of cutting ripe crop and collecting it. That process is called harvesting. Harvesting may be done with the help of sickle, that may be done with the help of sickle. Sickle is an agricultural implement that is something like this. So that is used by farmers to cut the crop manually. After cutting the crop, there is need of threshing. But when harvesting is done with the help of combine, means harvesting can be done with the help of sickle, or that may be done with the help of combine. Combine is a machine which do harvesting also, and that do with the at that time, same time, threshing also. Means that's why it is called combined, because this is the combination of threshing and this is the machine of combination of threshing and harvesting both. Both in the field only. So it is very easy by harvesting with the help of combine. It is very easy and very fast process, because in this process by harvesting with the help of combine, there is no need of threshing, and it take very less time. And harvesting with the sickles, that is slow process, that is done manually by the farmer with hand. The farmer have to cut the crop. And after that, there is need of threshing. Threshing means after harvesting, there is need of threshing. Threshing is the process of separating grains from the cut crop. Whatever cut crop is collected, after that, grains are there with the stalk. So that grains. The process of separation of grains from the chaff, that is called chaff. So chaff, the chaff of cut crop, that is called threshing. Means the process of separating grains from the chaff of the crop is called threshing. Now threshing can be done by various methods. That can be done by of this harvesting, as I told you, that can be done with the help of sickles and combine. So like that, threshing can be done with the help of bullocks. And this is slow process. It was done earlier. Nowadays rarely you can see this process of threshing. In this process, farmers scatter their cut crop in the on a even land, and with the help of a rope they tie various, means many animals, cattle, that may be bullocks. So mainly bullocks are used, and these bullocks are made to trample. They trample trample means they walk over the crop, cut crop. These animals, 4-5 animals are tied together with the rope, and they trample over the cut crop, and by their hoofs whatever grains are there in the cut crop, the grains are separated from the stalk, and the, after that farmer, after means trampling 4-5 hours, farmers separate the stalks of the crop and they collect the grains, and then they separate the grains. So this is also a process of threshing, but it is slow process. The other method is by beating the cut crop over a hard surface. In this process, farmers take some stalk of the crop with the spikes. Suppose the this is a crop and the spikes are there with the with that. So farmers hold it in the hand and they beat it at a hard surface, and whatever grains are there in the spikes, they are separated from the stalk. So they beat it either on means some hard surface, that should be some hard surface, so that grains may be separated. So this is also a process of threshing. This is also a slow process. And threshing machine, that can be done with the threshing machine also. Farmers put the cut crop with the mouth upside, and by this machine grains are separated easily and then fastly. So this is faster than these two methods. After the invention of the machine, it becomes very easy to take out grains from the chaff. So this is also a method of threshing by the using of threshing machine. So any of these three method can be acquired to separate the grains from the chaff. That process is called threshing. After threshing, whatever grains are found, that grains may have some small leaves of the plant, some parts of the stalk. So then also that have some impurities in that. To separate the grains from the pieces of leaves or etc., whatever is mixed with the grains, the next process is acquired, that is winnowing. In this process, this is the process of separating. Again, you can say word chaff, because that is the chaff is the crop plant parts, yeah, crop plants. So the process of separating chaff from the grains with the help of wind force, with the help of wind. In this process, a farmer have to drop the grains from some height, and the farmers take the grains in some container and drop it from some height. So whatever grains are there, they drop vertically just below the at that place, and whatever light impurities are there, they are blown away by the air. So grains are separated from the whatever stalks are there in the means whatever chaff is there in the crop plant of the crop plants. So that is separated, and only grains are separated. So this is the process of winnowing. विनोइंग कैन बी डन इन दैट कंडीशन व्हेन वट एवर टू थिंग्स आर मिक्स टूगेदर वन शुड बी लाइटर वन शुड बी हैवियर वट एवर हैवियर विल बी देयर दैट विल फॉल एट दैट प्लेस वर्टिकली एट दैट प्लेस एज ग्रेन्स ग्रेन्स आर हैवियर दैन द वट एवर चाफ इज देयर इन दैट तो चाफ इज लाइटर सो दैट इज ब्लोन अवे बाई द एयर एंड ग्रेन्स आर सेपरेटेड तो दिस इज द प्रोसेस ऑफ विनोइंग बाई द प्रोसेस ऑफ विनोइंग इन वट एवर ओनली ग्रेन्स आर सेपरेटेड तो नाउ वट एवर ग्रेन्स आर सेपरेटेड दैट इज अ क्रॉप कॉल क्रॉप प्रोड्यूस आर दैट इज कॉल ईल्ड ऑफ द क्रॉप ईल्ड ऑफ द क्रॉप दैट इज द ईल्ड ऑफ द क्रॉप वट एवर ग्रेन्स आर सेपरेटेड आफ्टर विनोइंग दैट इज द ईल्ड ऑफ द क्रॉप या क्रॉप प्रोड्यूस तो फार्मर्स गेट इट्स हिज क्रॉप प्रोड्यूस मीन दैट इज द क्रॉप ईल्ड अब सिंस आफ्टर ए लॉन्ग एफर्ट फार्मर्स डू फार्मर्स गेट द चांस ऑफ हार्वेस्टिंग इन दैट कंडीशन व्हेन द टाइम ऑफ हार्वेस्टिंग कम्स एट दैट टाइम फार्मर्स आर बिकेम वेरी हैप्पी सीइंग हिज क्रॉप इन गुड कंडीशन मीन्स राइप क्रॉप तो मेनी सेलिब्रेशंस has been acquired that is they are called the farmers celebrate various festivals such as Baisakhi that is Baisakhi Pongal Holi Diwali Bihu. So these various festivals are celebrated in various region. These are one common thing is there in these festivals that they are the harvest festivals. So these harvest festivals are celebrated on occasion of the harvesting of the crop of the farmer. So that's why they are called harvest festivals. After harvesting, threshing and winnowing, whatever grains are produced means that crop yield are obtained by the farmer, there is need to store it properly because after so long effort, whatever yield has been found, if that will be not stored properly, that may be spoiled by the microorganisms, that may be eaten by the some insects, pests. Miss, that should be safe from these enemies of the crop yield. So, food grains can be stored in small containers. If the food grain is in small quantity, they can be stored in the small containers, and they can be stored in the at large scale. If they are in large amount, they are stored in the either granaries to granaries are the godowns in which food grains are stored so that godown is called granaries and silos are the metal containers metallic specially designed metallic containers in which food grains are stored and they are safe from the microorganisms from the pests from insects from the fungus from bacteria so that is safe in that so in silos food grains are safe in granaries whatever large godowns are there in that whatever food grains are stored they are stored in gunny bags First, they are filled in gunny bags. Before filling it gunny bags, some precautions should be taken. That gunny bags must be free from the insects. Means gunny bags should be used, new gunny bags should be used, so that they may not have any insects in that. If old gunny bags are being used, then that should be cleaned properly, and that should be free from any insects, whatever the insects harm to the grains, so that should not be present in that. So that should be cleaned, and then it should be stored in that. Before keeping the food grains into the godown, the room, whatever in which they are, the gunny bags will be stacked, that should be washed properly, so that any hole of the rat should not be there. That room should not have moisture. So if moisture will be there, then the food grain will be spoiled. And before storing the food grains must be dried properly, because if food grains will have moisture in that, so that food grain will be spoiled by, there will be attack of fungus, bacteria, so that will be spoiled by them, and that will lose its germination also, means if in further it will be sown for growing crops further in the next season, then it will not germinate, that will lose its germination capability. So that should be dried properly. If it will be dried, then there will be no attack of microorganisms, means fungus or bacteria, and that will not be harmed by these microorganisms. And when it is stacked, so in the godown at some height, a platform of wooden platform should be made, that may be 1 foot also, approx 25 centimeter height, at some height of the ground surface. A wooden platform should be made, and on that wooden platform the gunny bags should be stacked in particular some rows, so that leaving the space, there should be space in between the wall of the room and whatever stacking of gunny bags are there, there should be space in that, so that after stacking the food grains, proper washing can be done time to time, means whatever people are involved in taking care of that granary, so they can wash from roaming in the room time to time in between the stacking also, so that it can be washed, that the food grains are safe, they are not being spoiled by being attacked by any insects or any microorganisms. And when it is stored in the silos, so in silos, since it is a metal container, then in metal container nowadays one new method has been involved, that whatever metal container means whatever in silos food grains are kept, in that nitrogen gas is supplied. When nitrogen gas is supplied, whatever oxygen is present in the silos, that oxygen gas is replaced by nitrogen gas. And since most of the organisms require oxygen for their survival, so whatever insects etc. are there in that, that insects are killed, means they do not survive in that in presence of only nitrogen. So food grains are safe in that, and that can be stored for longer time. Some of the perishable crop yields are put into the, like potato etc., kept in the vegetables are kept in the cold storage. In the cold storage, whatever microorganisms harm to the tuber of the potatoes, they do not harm, that is because they do not get proper temperature at that place. So there the crop yield is safe. So that is also a method of storage. Why this storage is necessary? The storage of crop yield is necessary, that is because whatever crop is produced, that is produced in a particular season, when in rabi season wheat crop is produced, in kharif season rice crop is produced, so if that will be stored it is stored so that it may be available till next crop season. And not only for that, there is need of storage of food. Government keep buffer stock. A buffer stock is kept by the maintained by the government so that in adverse condition, suppose anywhere flood comes or anywhere drought comes, where monsoon failure is there, and there is shortage of food in any particular area, so then government can supply food grains to the people's whatever victims are there. So that's why there is also need of storage of the food grains. So that's why governments keep a buffer stock. Buffer stock means keeping the food to provide it in adverse condition. Now one last topic is that is food from animals. We get food not only from plants, some of the food we get from animals also. Animals also are the source of food, as flesh, egg, cheese, milk, etc. We get from animals, honey, fish, so various things we get from the food we get from the animals. For that, rearing of animal and taking care of them at large scale for getting something of our use, that is called animal husbandry. That is called animal husbandry. That is called animal husbandry. Animals are reared and taken care and provide food, taken care about their health also. So if it is done at large scale, that is called animal husbandry, and it is done to get something of human use. That may be flesh, that may be egg, that may be milk. So for that purpose it is done. As human beings rear cattle, that is called dairy farming. In dairy farming, cattle are reared, that may be cow, that may be buffalo. So for the purpose of milk, generally it is done for the purpose of milk. Milk is produced, and from that milk we get many things like ice cream, cheese, curd, means milk products are prepared from that. So in dairy farming, cattle are reared for the production of milk. And whatever animals are provide milk, whatever animals are reared for the purpose of milk, they are called milching animals. Milching animals. This term, if you are not knowing, then keep in mind. What are milching animals? The animals which produce milk, which provide milk, like cow and buffalo, they are called milching animals. Milching, M-I-L-C-H-I-N-G, they are called milching animals. So milching animals are generally reared in dairy farming. That is called dairy farming. They are reared for the production of milk. Some birds are also reared. That is called poultry farming. In poultry farming, various birds are reared, like hen, duck, some other birds are reared for the production of egg, either for the production of egg or for the flesh. So that is called poultry farming. For rearing of fish is called PC culture. Rearing of fish for the for obtaining fish, that is called PC culture. For rearing of honey bee, that is called apiculture. Rearing of honey for the production of honey, that is called rearing of honey bee. फॉर द प्रोडक्शन ऑफ हनी इज कॉल्ड एपीकल्चर, रेयरिंग ऑफ फिश दैट इज कॉल्ड पीसी कल्चर, रेयरिंग ऑफ बर्ड्स फॉर द प्रोडक्शन ऑफ एग और फ्लैश दैट इज कॉल्ड पोल्ट्री फार्मिंग, एंड रेयरिंग ऑफ कैटल्स फॉर द प्रोडक्शन ऑफ मिल्क दैट इज कॉल्ड डेयरी फार्मिंग. दीज आर आर द पार्ट्स ऑफ एनिमल हस्बेंड्री. वन क्वेश्चन आई एम गिविंग यू दैट यू मे आंसर. क्वेश्चन इज व्हाट इज कॉमन इन द फेस्टिवल्स ऑफ पोंगल, बैसाखी, होली, दिवाली, नवान्न एंड बिहू. तो व्हाट इज कॉमन इन दिस ऑल फेस्टिवल्स. तो दिस मच अबाउट दिस चैप्टर. Now whatever confusions will be there, that will you will ask in live classes. Thank you.